Have you ever thought of an idea, a crazy idea? One that was so obscure and creative that it would be impossible to translate on screen. Or potentially people might look at you weird if you told them it. Maybe it's a fight scene done entirely through pockets. Or a sexual dance party bursting through multiple ceilings of an apartment complex. Well, I'm happy to say you're not alone, and there are two filmmakers who think the same way. And it's these guys.
Wait, are you in? No!
Turn down for what?
Whether you enjoy their stuff or not, there's one thing for sure. Their method of filmmaking is truly inspirational. They have a large slate of dozens of music videos, several short films, and one obscure feature.
We just goof off until we both laugh, and that's when we know an idea is good. And that was how my sketch troupe worked, and that's how our process worked.
Now, their attitude towards storytelling resembles the sort of youthfulness that you had when you were a kid. Anything is possible, and no idea is too ridiculous. They use the creative method that I like to call, what if? What if there was a music video where a guy fell down the stairs the entire time? Or what if we made an emotional drama about a farting corpse? What if you had a traditional breakup scene where a girlfriend broke up with her boyfriend on the beach?
This doesn't leave the fucking beach.
Drew, chill, okay? You're freaking a freshman now.
And then out of sorrow, he goes to his buddies and they form a massive brobot. That's right, brobot. Essentially, the style of storytelling is created by taking two ideas and putting them together. You have a traditional, almost cliche story, and then you apply almost a childish or stoned idea and put it in the mix.
We're gonna get a band back for you, bro.
Utilizing the what-if writing method is one of the most important exercises as a storyteller, and it's where the best ideas are created. And I think it's one that more filmmakers should use. So what if you had to do a flashback? Would you do it like this? Or would you do it like this? This type of filmmaking can be seen in every single project they do. Sometimes they start with just an obscure image, and other times it's a what-if scenario. So not only is their filmmaking process incredibly inspiring from a story perspective, but it's also very inspiring from an editing perspective. So I want to talk about one of their most ridiculous videos to date, which is DJ Snake and Little John's Turn Down For What music video. So I'm going to be breaking down the edit, taking out a 1 minute section, and talk about how their kinetic camera movement and digital scale-ins can create a lot of energy, part of an edit, and how you guys can implement this into your project. So without further ado, let's get into it.
Turn down for what?
What gives Daniels their signature style is the constant use of obvious digital camera movement. While most films try to steer away from the obvious digital tricks, Daniels embrace them, giving their projects an animated look. Now, while this movement here could easily be created practically, the digital jitter makes us feel like we're watching a cartoon or animation. The duo also utilizes practical movement mixed with digital. In this shot, we have the camera pushing in manually, so the operator would have walked towards the talent. But in post-production, to add additional energy, there's also a slow scale-in on top. Fast scale-outs are also utilized. When the couple rotates to face the camera, there's this awesome quick scale-out applied. This transitions us beautifully from this shot to this one.
Turn down for what?
This is one that I'm gonna talk about. It's mom's close-up face and then wide face of her dancing. Now, static scale-ins are also utilized to enhance reaction. In this situation, they used a static scaled-up shot that cuts to the wide version. This effect was most likely created by blowing up a 4 or 6K image. What's interesting about this sequence is they don't diversify their angles. So, meaning they don't go to the left, right, or an overhead. They actually play from the same perspective and do a lot of the movement in post-production or with a slow push-in or a slow push-out. Next thing is this push-in towards Mr. Daniel here. And what's fascinating about it is there is a shake to the camera, but that is actually a manual camera shake that was done, and the shot is just sped up to move into Daniel. Okay, I'm gonna touch on this series of shots here. What's fascinating about them is they play out within three close-ups and then one wide. Two of them are detail shots of his crotch dancing, and then one is a wide. Think of this sequence as a recipe. You have your ingredients, which would be the close-ups that make up the shot, and then you have the wide, which is basically the food finally cooked. The next bit, again, is using that quick push-in, that digital push-in, to transition us into another scene. Okay, so this next part is this crazy fast montage sequence. Each shot plays out for about 5 to 7 frames each. Now this really builds up the pace with the edits, and each edit is to the beat of the song, so that builds up the energy. But this is what I would call a breathing shot. Essentially, if you have any sort of fast-paced edits, it's really nice to have some sort of calm after the storm, and even before the storm. So we have the calm, and then they come bursting through the ceiling.
Turn down for what?
It is without a doubt that this directing duo has an incredible style and a unique flavor to creating narratives. Now, while their stories and style may not cater to everyone's interest, there's one thing for sure. They're giving an oversaturated market a unique spin. If you like their stuff and want to watch a longer formatted short, I recommend watching Interesting Ball. And if you have time and want to watch a feature film of theirs, take a look at Swiss Army Man. It's great. So take down your boundaries and start thinking outside the box. Merge your ideas and creativity to enhance your writing process. Put your characters in weird situations, set up the impossible scenarios, and ask yourself, what if?
Okay, buddy.
Thank you guys so much for watching. This video was incredibly fun to make, and I learned a whole heck of a lot while doing it. If you like this video and want to take a look at more, take a look at my YouTube channel, hit that like button, smash the subscribe, and I'll see you guys in another video.